as long as we can confirm that,
You know what's funny? You're the only one here that can say that shit and it not be a fucking bullshit lie.
Yeah, that's true.
That's good, because I don't think Justin understands how biology works at all, considering he called them egg happies.
Egg!
Hey, Steve, but I was right. He confirmed it.
Egg happies is what I get for breakfast.
I personally take mine scrambled.
God. I'll have egg salads.
What are those over medium? So
hey, alright, Justin, send me fucking pictures of my character sheet so I can put it in the app.
Oh, right, right.
You were
give
about
me...
to ask for pictures of your egg happies.
Yeah, just give me your phone. I'm gonna put your character in.
Hey, Justin, there's can I have app. Some pictures of your egg happies?
There's the app.
Sure, buddy.
I was gonna try to import it, but I didn't have a Google thing.
Oh, I lowered my second monitor, so now my iPad doesn't fit underneath it. Sad. I wonder if I can access this character through Google Drive on my desktop. I doubt it, because probably
shit, I fucking misread what I typed. I thought... You know how, like, whenever you have it, it's up in the address bar? I thought I wrote egg herpes.
Oh. Alright.
Wait,
like,
what?
Don't worry about it. You'll understand the elder.
They saved the kids.
Good.
They're back in town. There was a big feast. You're all being celebrated as heroes. And,
Oh, Curtis killed that dude that you hate. Not really, but I wanted to get your hopes up.
Let me get them up and kill them real fast.
Curtis did get called a pet and told he had to be kept on a leash outside again. So. Someone did burn down all tree though. It's real sad. I'm kidding.
Yeah, I
playing with my emotions.
Yeah, Gary just got trimmed a little bit.
Did you give Gary a haircut?
Do you see that like farmland by the castle? He's multiplying.
If dug up with a shovel is what you consider a haircut, sure.
Hello. We're carrying him with us. He's only partially grown.
Yeah. We only have a toy.
We're gonna be carrying a corpse.
Okay.
I'm literally glad I sent you those screenshots.
This is one of the reasons I asked him to be sent.
Yeah.
Did you lose your character sheet or something?
Well, I got a new phone.
Oh. You know, I'm probably gonna have to remake my character now that I think about it.
You can do an import of yours. Hers, the reason why she didn't get two is because her phone died. Like, it just...
Oh, it's just broken.
Yeah, it just decided, I'm done.
Like, didn't we try to pull up the recovery thing? It pulled up and then wouldn't let us do anything.
Do you not use ABD? Can you use ABD to recover stuff?
What's that?
It's a thing that basically puts your phone in developer mode and then you can write changes to it through USB.
No, this phone, I don't know how the newer phones work with it, but this phone literally you can't access until it's powered on and on the home screen.
That's stupid.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I mean, to be fair, I had it for, what, since high school?
You can bypass that, but
it's a lot of effort.
It's a pain in the butt.
It was time. It was time for a new phone.
Yeah.
That thing, I've replaced 3 batteries in it, couldn't keep any memory open. It was freezing on unlocking the phone. So, I needed a new one. I wanted to trade it in, but when I looked at how much it was worth $15.
I'm surprised it was worth that much that old.
Yeah.
Really?
Apparently this thing is using the revised Rangers. I gotta find the revised Ranger shit.
So, Marley, since you're here, I'm working on a little separate campaign. Would you like to join? Probably be like 2 or 3 sessions.
You're cutting in and out, Curtis.
I was just saying if she wanted to make a character for a little session that I was working on.
You're still cutting out?
Fuck!
Oh, well, actually, I heard that. Never mind.
Marley, create character for my game.
What was the name of that new D&D book that came out?
Tasha.
Create a character for your game?
Yeah, I'm doing like a small session. If you want to join.
When are we doing it?
I don't know. I haven't fully made it yet, but I'm working on it.
I'll make a character. I'll make one. What kind of thing is
that? I'm doing like a gothic
regular
manor. Yeah, it's like 5e. It'll be starting at level 5.
Okay. I'll come up with a character idea.
Okay.
I'm actually in the middle of trying to make a system. I don't know how it's going to work yet, but I'm partially through the rules.
Okay, babe. You didn't get this choice the first time you were playing. Pretty much you get a choice between marking enemies or getting favored enemies.
What are favored enemies?
Favored enemies, you get like bonuses to checks concerning them. Like if you needed to track one, you needed to speak its language. If your shit was like, man, I really don't like orcs, you suddenly know how to speak orc and know how to track them properly.
I want favorable.
But then there's marking that lets you do extra damage on something, but you have to be stalking it, so you have to stealth and stare at it for a minute straight, and then.
So I'm basically Myersing the.
Yeah, pretty much. You get extra damage on rolls if you stalk it for a minute, but it only works on that creature that you use it on.
I want the favored.
Okay.
That makes more sense to me.
Oh, she's level 3 now, so she can pick her archetype too.
Yeah, this is still level 1 though, so.
Wait, she's level 3?
We're all level 3.
Are we?
Yeah, we leveled up last session.
Okay, Marley, here's another choice that they added in. Do you want the ability to have chosen terrain, or do you want to gain languages and expertise?
Languages and expertise.
Actually, Ryan, you may not be leveled up, because I remember you were a good bit XP behind me, and I'm only at 918.
Are you sure?
I thought I was equivalent with Marley.
Yeah.
I know that you and Curtis were higher than us, but I thought I was the same as Marley.
The more people that I can talk to, the better.
Yeah, I think y'all are both level 2. You'll have to have it 900 XP.
Yeah, I have 861 experience.
Okay.
I don't know how much I had. Level.
Yeah, you have the same.
I was
same
just thinking
dream.
That we all doubled up.
I think we can me say and Marley I'm are just slightly lower.
No,
okay, what do you want your skill expertise to be in? Whatever you put it in, you'll get double proficiency bonus on.
If I remember what
choose
I had in my inventory.
Between, it has nothing to do with your inventory.
Well, the weapon that I had.
It has nothing to do with them either. I'm about to tell you your choices.
Okay.
You can choose athletics, which is for climbing, swimming, shit like that. Deception, you know what that's for. Intimidation, medicine, nature, religion, or stealth.
Deception.
I'm gonna go ahead and make
deception,
and then do a recovery.
So you're gonna be crazy good at making sure people don't know that you're a changeling.
That way I'll have both.
I mean, my what? The two people in my group that saw me turn into a fucking plant are the only ones that know, I think. Or did the whole party see me change into a plant?
I think we all saw you change into a plant.
Cool.
Yep.
That's fine.
While you're doing that, I'm gonna go ahead and create my level 3. That way, as soon as I hit it, I can just swap over and I don't have to take time for that.
Okay.
That way I'll just have it at the ready.
Mm-hmm.
What the fuck? Are you serious?
No.
God fucking damn it.
I'm not serious at all.
What happened?
I accidentally fucking double clicked and undid all my work. This shit,
oh,
yeah.
Wait.
I know the answers this time.
Oh, that was easy enough. Never mind, I'm not gonna bother. Because I don't have to choose anything for this next level.
Why?
Are you gonna make him double click again?
Okay, let me see what. I should have already had this choice.
Good.
All right. What do you want your preferred fighting style to be? You can choose archery, blind fighting, which gives you 10 feet of blind sight, defense, druidic warrior, which gives you 2 druid cantrips, dueling, which requires you to use a single one-handed weapon, but gives you plus two damage on it. Thrown weapon fighting, which gives you bonuses to throwing shit, or two weapon fighting, which gives you bonuses to dual wielding.
Druidic.
Druidic?
Makes sense to me. From the stuff that I had with my background and stuff.
And you're sure? Because this can't be changed.
Am I what?
Are you sure? Because it can't be changed.
Yeah.
Because it's just cantrips. They don't do a whole lot.
Rather than nothing.
Well, so is extra attack on archery, dual wielding damage.
Fine, give me the dual wielding.
I mean, any of it's good. I'm just telling you, it's not as the choice you're choosing isn't as good as the others. I'm just giving you a heads up.
And it's my choice. What would I put?
Okay. I was giving you the option. I'm just letting you know. Two druid cantrips.
Hey, you get Shillelagh out of that, though. Shillelagh is pretty fucking awesome.
No, you fucking don't.
What are the druid cantrips? Because now that I think about it, I don't know any of them other than Shillelagh.
I'll see how it is. Everybody gets it but me.
They also get guidance. Guidance is pretty fucking good.
Okay, do you
I didn't know they got guidance.
Do you want bonus spells, which it's just, at level 3, your current level, it gives you speak with animals, and, you can cast it once a day? Or do you want to be able to detect creatures for up to a mile?
Speak.
Okay, later on you'll get Beast Sense, Speak with Plants, which you can already pretty much do, and Locate Creature as a spell once a day, so.
You should give her an ability called Summon Bush.
What do you want your archetype to be?
I don't know.
There's Beastmaster, Fey Wanderer, the Gloom, which I think that's the one you were doing, the shadowy one?
Yeah, that's what it was, yeah.
Okay, that's the one you wanted, I remember that. Okay.
Gloomstalker pretty damn good.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure which one's better between it and Horizon Walker, but those are the two that I would say are probably the best ones.
Okay, Marley.
Mm-hmm.
I need you to roll a d10 twice. It's the little diamond bastards.
It's the one that's just slightly bigger than the two pyramids ass to ass.
Huh?
8 and 6.
Okay, that puts you at an even 30 health. Alright. So, 30 HP. What,
did I roll a d8? I think I rolled the wrong dice.
Show me which dice you rolled. Yeah, that's the wrong dice. It has the number 10 on it.
Well, obviously.
It actually
which
doesn't.
One?
It has a 0 on it.
Which one?
The one's closest to you.
This one?
Mm-hmm.
Well, Merlin, leave it alone. Alright, I'm rolling it twice. 2 and 5.
Okay.
I mean, you can keep the 6 mate.
Having to fix this stuff takes a minute. Marla. Making a link in general chat. Click that. Look at the cantrips. Choose 2. God damn, Revised Ranger gets a lot of shit, doesn't it?
Yeah, they had to make up for how bad Base Ranger was. Because realistically, the only thing the Base Ranger really had going for it that other classes didn't do better was scouting and exploring, and even then it's arguable. Their action economy was all fuckety.
Well, Gloomstalker gets extra attacks.
Yeah, no, Gloomstalker's great. That's the reason that they started making all the Ranger subclasses really good. Is so that it can make up for how bad the base class was. Gloomstalker and Horizon Walker are both really good.
Okay, go to this page now. Send you another link. Tell me when you're there.
I'm here. I'm picking languages.
You're going to choose 2 from the first list and 1 from the second list. If you don't want 1 from the second list, you can sub it for 1 from the first list.
2 from first, 1 from second. Okay, so... I want... Do we not all just know common?
You already have common, yeah. You don't have to worry about that.
I want Elvish and Elvish and Gnomish, I think. And then on the other one, I want Sylvan.
Would make sense. Okay.
Merlin, what are you doing?
What? Now you need to choose two more languages from that list.
Okay. From the second one?
From either one.
Alright. I want...
Because you chose the two extra languages for your thing.
I want... Draconic. And... What is deep speech? Like... It says aboleths and cloakers.
Deep speech is the speaking of the creatures that are like
aberrations.
Yeah, aberrant speaks. It's like mind flayers and like pretty much big
things.
If it
has a squid for a face.
Yeah, if it's got a squid for a face, you can speak.
I don't know if we'll ever encounter it, but I want deep speech.
Okay.
Actually, in character, that kind of makes sense considering changelings are like half doppelganger.
Yeah.
True.
Okay, your character is now fully created. Let's see here. Tyler. What is your current XP?
918.
That's what I'm gonna set hers to.
Should I also set mine?
Yeah, you should probably set yours too since you didn't write yours down. I'll get that.
Well, no, I know how much mine is.
How much is yours?
Ryan and Marley were a little bit behind.
Yeah, me and Marley had the same amount.
Oh, then let's
go
with
yours.
We were
lower than them.
What was yours?
Let me pull that back up. Mine is at 861.
You're like the kid who reminded the teacher that it was fucking homework.
It's
yeah,
okay,
you did
Marley.
It, you did it
we're
to
literally,
earlier.
We are literally 39 XP away from going to 3.
You guys, did you write down your quest completion XP?
I didn't. I couldn't.
I don't know, maybe.
They've been behind, Justin.
Yeah.
Hmm.
We got behind on second session.
Remember
yeah,
when me
we,
and Curtis
yeah.
worked at that house, you gave me
yeah.
and Curtis bonus XP.
Oh. So you're
yeah.
not technically level 3 yet.
And then I did the blood sacrifice. And didn't get a garbage roll.
Okay, I don't want to have to undo and fix all this, so we'll just keep these for now. And whenever you hit level 3, you just want to hit the level up button. You know what?
If I level up, I don't level up.
Hold on, give me a second. Actually, this might be good for you. Ranger level 2. Okay, I'm just fixing it to where you can do it like normal.
Justin, why gotta be slow as fuck?
Motherfucker, this takes a minute. Whenever you have to completely redo a character.
Why don't you just do a... Wait, are you using you're using the same app, right?
Yeah, but she can't...
You can recover a level 2 character.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. I'm recovering the level 2 right now. But I have to retype in some stuff. Now I've got to retype in your languages again. It was bullshit. Common, Elvish, Gnomish, Sylvan. Conic. Deep speech. Okay. That'll take care of that. All this is fixed. And the last thing.
I got your toes here. I got your toes here.
Your gold that you didn't get from last time added. Marley, I'm gonna send you your other pages because I'm not typing all that in.
What all, like the?
Your flaws and all that.
Right. That's fun. Ow! Ow. Okay, I get it. Fuck. Justin, hold.
Nope. Okay, so now whenever it comes time for you to level up, just level up like normal. And all will be good.
Damn, I really want a ham and cheese sandwich right now.
Oh, you got time. Go ahead.
I don't have the necessary ingredients. And I don't want to go to Walmart.
You can roll 3D dice.
Yeah, technically you just roll a D6 and then go... 2, 4, and 6.
Shut the fuck up. I meant three
here.
Dimensional.
Here.
Jackass.
Okay, now what was your XP again, Ryan?
It is
864.
One.
No.
One?
Yeah. 861.
Marley, what was your alignment? This is the last thing I need from your page.
Boys, I'm getting pretty tired. I'm gonna go to sleep.
Chaotic neutral, of course. Why not?
I was chaotic neutral.
I looked at it. I'm
being honest.
There is your character finished. And now we can get to the game.
Okay, you wanna go take a nap?
All right. That took a minute. Okay. Curtis, go fuck yourself.
What did I do?
What did Curtis do?
I heard him. He's being a faggot. Now. Okay, so you guys had a crazy night. I'm gonna put you guys back at the tavern. You guys went...
Oh, go ahead, sorry.
The last part of your mission, you saved the children, everyone was happy with you, and all that good shit. You guys had your party, you're waking up kinda groggy from the fucking alcohol, but you remember you still have a mission to complete, including your personal missions. Ryan, you still have to find your brother and all that. Let's see. You remember that the last thing that the witch told you is that if you're looking for the source of the haunted girl's affliction, it could be, she couldn't tell you exactly where it was, but she could tell you someone who could, and she pointed you out to the cave south of Lutheport, where it's supposed to be a sea hag in a cave. As a catch up. So from here you guys can do whatever the hell you want.
I have exactly zero clues as to where those other fuckers are, so I'm gonna say that we should not do that.
Other fuckers?
Yeah, the people that took my brother. I know their name, but I have no idea. Like, I don't have any leads on where they're at, so I figure as we play and do stuff, I might get those eventually from somewhere.
Yeah, I figure we could get supplies and then go to the cave.
Okay. Works for me.
You all got paid, so you should have money to spend on supplies if you want to buy things in town.
That's another thing, too. I don't know how much money I had.
I already put it down. One thing I didn't put down that you might want to. Forgot about this. Remember whenever you spent your money on that bag of unmentionable grotesqueness?
Yeah.
Need to add that to your.
How much was it?
It wasn't the price. You just need to add it to your list. I already fixed your goal.
Oh, okay.
You just need to add it to your list of items, because it's pretty much the only thing you've gotten this whole time. This is a disgusting bag that makes people vomit.
It's worth it.
Okay. So, where are you guys wanting to go? You wanting to buy things? I need to know where you're headed.
Probably food, water.
What?
Food and water.
You can drop one gold and give yourself a week of rations.
Alright, how far is the place? How far is the place we're going to?
Let's see here. If we migrate our crew to the map page. Get zoomed in here. You guys are here in Rivers Rock, and you're headed to Loopport, which is over here. You'll be traveling for a couple of weeks on the road.
So it might be best to get a few weeks worth of rations.
Yeah, I'm gonna drop 5 gold.
Same.
And then that'll give me my water and like rations and stuff.
Remember, you can always find food on the road, too, so.
That's fine.
This is cheap enough.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You will get there in that time, though, only if you have a cart. Walking on foot will take longer.
Yeah, I was going to say, if we could do, like, horses or donkeys.
Yeah, you guys might want to look into buying a cart for the crew.
Okay.
Wouldn't be a bad idea.
Or if we could hitch a ride with one of the merchants. Yeah, let's go up to one of the stable owners.
Hey, if there's people already traveling that way, we could agree to like guard them.
Escort.
In exchange for the traveling.
Okay. Let me roll a percentile and see if you guys notice.
I mean, that's if they want to do it. That's just a suggestion.
Oh yeah, I'm just gonna see if there's even any traders leaving out today. No, not at all.
Okay. Well,
all right, let's go to.
I'm out of the loop, so I don't know.
Let's go to the cart merchants.
Well, there's not, like, cart merchants, per se.
Or a waggy? Wagon? Dune wagon?
You would go to an artisan. They build stuff. Like, you go to a woodworker or something. Most of the trade is handled in this district here in the town.
Okay. And we wouldn't necessarily need a cart if we got, like, just...
I mean, yeah, you can...
Why are you upside down?
Why not?
He just keeps doing it. I've been turning him sideways and shit, and he just keeps going back upside down.
I don't know how you're doing that, but it's interesting.
Just click on your portrait, and I'll have the little arrow thing above it, or the little box, and you rotate.
Interesting. pointless.
Wait. Interesting. Wait. Where did I?
Interesting. What? What's there to be confused about?
Oh, I know what I need to do. I need to look for a pristine pet leash.
You want to try that again without the lag?
I want a pristine pet leash.
Oh my god, it fucked up again.
Say the last two words.
The last two words is all we need.
Pet leash.
Pet leash, okay.
Oh, so that you can try to be allowed into the noble's home?
Yeah.
We do need to talk to them before we leave.
Oh my god.
Why do you want to talk to them before you leave?
The nobles, so we can tell them what's going on.
Are you talking about the one that doesn't like you, or the one with the butler?
The one with the butler.
Okay.
No. I'm trying to think. The one who hired us.
Oh,
initially.
Yeah, the one that keeps calling Curtis a pit.
Yeah.
That's the son. I'm talking about the nobleman himself.
Yeah.
Can we please kill that dude before we...
No. I mean, he's a noble and he'd be wanted criminals at that point.
I'll take it.
Thus would be the end of the campaign.
Yeah, you're good.
Thanks for saving our city, Shank.
But you did kill that guy.
Son.
The rules still apply. We'd be fucking wanted men.
Are you trying to do a random person in town?
You might actually get away with it.
Yeah, you'd be fine. Them right so much.
Yeah.
She'd be fine up until people that can have true seeing come in, and then they're like, oh, well, no.
Yeah.
Okay, so. Curtis says he's going to go see about buying a cart. So I'm going to go with him first, since no one else said anything yet.
I don't know what we...
I'll come with him.
I was typing my stuff in. So, am I still working for that lady?
No, that's been... We've been done with that.
No.
Yeah, that was a weekly thing. You did it that 1 week, and then...
We're about to go south to Lootport, or whatever it's called. There's a sea hag that could give us a location to the...
Why is this picture so small, Justin? Like, I've zoomed in, but it's, like, weird.
You see the zoom thing at the top? You have to use that to zoom.
That's the weirdest thing.
Okay, so if you guys are wanting to buy one, it looks like the cheapest you'll be able to get out with is a single horse. If you want to buy more than one horse, that's up to you, but single horse is 75 gold. And a single carriage is 100 gold, so between you, if you can afford... Well, you should be able to afford that.
Yeah,
between all
of
you.
I think we could individually afford that.
How much was it?
175 for both?
Yeah, 175 for both.
We could split the cost for that, and that wouldn't be that
bad.
Where's
my gold? Did you put gold in?
Yes, I put gold in on yours. Did I? Or did it undo?
But where?
It's here, let me see.
Is it in this?
Yeah, it's that thing right there. You should have 150. Yeah.
I never put it down there.
So, 25 by before.
Okay, yeah, so you guys should be able to afford that. The carriage can hold quite a bit of shit, so.
So it'd be like 45 gold apiece?
44.
Okay.
So I'll just...
Alright, we'll do 44.
44 each?
Yeah.
44 each.
It's like 43.75 each, so.
Okay.
So you guys, now between you, have a carriage and a horse.
What are we naming the horse?
Yeah, you should name the horse.
It ships its iron cock and balls. What's the horse look like?
Eh. You know what? Surely someone's made this.
I want to name it.
I want to name it Baskins.
I was going to say Rapid Feet, but okay.
Rapid Feet.
My character does not feel the same way I do about horses, which is to say I don't trust or like horses at all. I think they're shifty, shady assholes.
You, huh?
Corn cob.
Corn cob.
Okay.
You just want to name it Kim? That's a pretty shifty name.
Kim Horstashian.
Well, my horse doesn't, or my character doesn't necessarily feel the same way I do about it. He doesn't care about horses, but I personally don't like horses.
All right, settled. The horse's name is Deborah.
Okay. I haven't even rolled its gender yet. All right. So
either way, it's Deborah.
It's Deborah.
We're making a horse character right now. This is happening.
Deborah.
There we go.
Abracadabra.
Abracadabra. Yes. That's it. That's Abra's a surname.
Sir Abracadabra the third, the fourth.
You trade it. Oh my god, can we trade it? We need to trade it and evolve it.
Oh my god.
What a Pokemon.
Abracadabra.
I mean, with a name like Abracadabra, it could be.
It is.
Okay, it is a female. Bitch weighs 1,550 pounds. She a thick bitch.
That's a Deborah.
I've never met a thick Deborah.
You've obviously never been to a strip club.
No, I haven't actually.
Okay, it's your standard brown horse with the black mane.
What color's the tail?
Black.
Does the mane make it look like it has a mohawk?
No.
He rolled for a mohawk.
All right, I admire the conviction. Let's press on.
I thought for a minute with that big pause, he just didn't even deem my question worth answering.
I know he didn't. I know that silence. It speaks volume.
It does, it does.
All right, so.
Hold on, we're almost done.
What Dear color? God, how much do you have to roll for this damn horse?
No, it's not particularly that I have to roll for this, but since you guys made this a thing, we're going to go all out on it.
What color are the eyes?
Oh my god.
How big is its dick?
You know what? I just rolled on a horse defect table. And
why does that exist?
Please tell me if the horse has autism.
There are roll tables for absolutely everything you could dream of for D&D.
Okay. What type of hooves does it have?
I got one that I didn't really like, and so I tried rolling again, and I got the same thing, so I think Destiny calls. This motherfucker has a gimp leg.
Oh my god, that seems like an abracadabra.
So, you guys got a horse with a limp.
Well, then we need to ask for a discount.
You know what? Sure, you guys get 5 gold back.
Hell yeah.
Each. So, 20 gold discount for getting the one with the gimp leg.
Good. I need the money. I'm saving up for armor.
I'm saving up to buy more random shit.
Alright.
It doesn't affect it a whole hell of a lot. It's just slightly slower than normal horse, but it does have a cartoonishly goofy limp whenever it walks. And with it being fat as shit, I'm sure that only makes it more enjoyable for your imagination.
Can it?
You didn't answer my question.
Can it neigh like Scooby?
No.
My question was, how big is its dick?
It does not have a dick. It's a female.
Yeah. It's a hermaphrodite horse.
This is 2021. It can be whatever it wants.
I'm not rolling. I'm not even going to try to find a chart. to figure out what sexual bullshit
it's
this
a
thing
D,
has
it's
going
a
on
D
in this
eight.
Life. I am not going to go on here and find every fucking rainbow color of the LGBT table to roll off of for a goddamn horse.
Hang on, it's
this
a D.
This is just like these fuckers saying that their dogs are vegetarian. It does not work.
It's a D8.
It does not work.
It's just a D8.
Look,
it's like,
Curtis, I'm gonna need you to roll off a cliff, alright? I just need you to roll off a cliff and quit talking. We're continuing. You guys have a cart and a horse that is now fat and a gimp leg.
That's a 14 plus 6. What do I roll off? Do I stick the landing?
Superhero landing.
You drop head first on a penis, like mouth open and a gape. You are now impaled, cloacan style, through the throat and out the ass.
Damn.
Now let's
got a pretty good big penis then.
Let's continue.
Oh god, I can't hear anything.
You weren't supposed to deep throat the Grand Canyon.
Oh. Alright, let's go.
Okay. You have a cart.
Let's go.
You guys have supplies on the cart because you all just bought a fuck ton of food.
Did I get a leash?
They bought a fuck ton of food. I did not.
You plan on getting food from the wilds while you're out?
No, I only bought a week worth of food. If I need more than that, then I'll go get it then.
Okay.
Alright, let's hit it.
Okay, are you guys planning on talking to the noble about why you're even... Because you're kind of trying to save his daughter at this point, it seems, so... Are you even going to tell him?
Yeah, let's do that. We'll relay the information.
This guy here.
Okay.
So, my character doing
Thank
anything?
You, Tyler. Yeah, you're with them, so you can do whatever you want while you're...
Well,
stuff.
My character was not over there, but...
Jesus Christ.
For
what
the LARPing person, this is why we take so long to play D&D.
All right, now.
Well, it took long because it took an hour to make one character.
He rolls.
But that's beside the point. Let's move on. We're moving on. Knock on the door.
He's looking through papers.
Yeah, I am looking through papers while you guys are fucking around, Mister. We take forever because Justin's doing something, Mister. I can't move my goddamn character to this direction, but I want to blame Justin for it. See this little area right here? You see that right there?
What the
fuck?
What is going on? What just happened?
I knocked on the door.
Would it be easier if your character was this big? Would that help?
Yes, I'm a
your character looks
I'm a kimono dragon. Fear me.
Okay.
Curtis,
let's continue.
Base boosted.
Let's fucking continue. You walk up to the house, just as a refresher, it's the House of Burn, the guy you're talking to, is where the fuck is it? Brendis, his name is Brendis.
Alright.
Brenda.
Brendis.
Brenda.
It's
not the horse's
name.
Now
Brenda.
No.
Look, we're not doing this. We're trying to get through something in this goddamn game.
Alright, let's go.
You guys have managed to buy a horse. That is the culmination of the last 30 minutes. You have bought a horse.
Like 15.
No. We have been doing this for 20 minutes.
Alright. We're bypassing the first hour and a half. That doesn't count. We're knocking on the door.
Okay. You knock on the door, the same butler answers. He looks you over and he says, what can the House of Burn do for you?
We're just gonna relay the information because I don't remember everything.
So you're just gonna start spouting off about the fact that the little girl is cursed and the father is gonna die because of it, and the fact that you might have a lead on how to cure it.
Well, I meant that we're going to go try to see if we can find a cure for it. Yeah. We went to the place where we found the kids. There was a witch there that told us that a sea hag that lives in a cave by Lootport may know of the demon or like this thing that's possessing your daughter. We are gonna go see if we can talk to them to see if we can cure your daughter.
Okay. The as you say this, the father, the actual Brindis guy, he kind of opens the door from the side as he was standing there listening. He's got some crutches on his arms as he's walking up towards the edge of the door frame. He says, "If you can save my daughter, I'd be eternally indebted to you. Mother of Ravens hasn't spoken to me in a long time. I haven't known of my daughter's illness. Whenever you make it to Lootport, I'll have some of my contacts there get you some arrangements and help you out."
Alright. I'm going to... I kind of want to tell him to stay alive. I want to see him again. I'd like to see him again. Maybe we could have a drink once he feels better.
What?
If we cure him.
Okay, well... He nods you along. He says if you manage to complete this quest, he will reward you handsomely.
Alright.
As he nods and kind of bows to you for a moment, he kind of coughs up some fucking blood up onto the porch there. And the butler whisks him away to his room and shuts the door behind him.
Alright. Hell, if you guys are ready, let's hit it.
Let's do it.
Alright.
Let's go.
Okay. You hop upon your cart. Jesus fucking Christ, who's doing that?
That'd be Tyler.
You guys make way to, there, which is actually in this direction.
Do we want to pick up Stitches? Or is he got a job, didn't he?
Yeah, he's cooking.
Okay.
You want to see the little chef hat he's got on?
Yeah, look in the general chat, it's right there. He's beautiful. It's now pinned. So if you click pinned, he'll be there. Looking you in your face.
Stitches is forever.
I'd rather look at that picture of Stitches than that picture of Curtis.
Okay, so you guys make your way out of Rockport. Or Rivers Rock, rather. Rockport was the other game. This is Rivers Rock. Okay. Moving you over here. Party is now headed to Lootport. We roll dice.
Nope. Champ.
Oh my god, you guys are some...
We're crafty.
What are we?
We're crafty.
Okay. What are we, Justin?
Yeah.
You're some lucky fuckers.
Oh, okay.
Every time that I roll you guys for random encounters, you roll good encounter.
How are we supposed to get XP if we only get good encounter?
Well, it's just how things work, man. I don't know. Do you just want me to start... You know what? You guys just need to murder everything in town like we do in Divinity.
Probably.
Okay.
Alright, we'll turn the card around and go back to the butler.
You have to roll a murder
hobo. Okay, so you guys are making your way down the trail.
How is it going to take us multiple weeks to get there? It's only 5 feet away. This is bullshit.
We've broken him.
I wish you could see the look
I thought he kicked me out of chat. I'm like, okay, I deserve
Tyler's it. Tyler's now banished.
Mm-hmm. Tips Fedora.
Okay.
Tips banished.
Sad boy hours. Alright, so you guys are making your way along. You're heading from Rivers Rock to Blueport. On your way there, a few days in, you guys decide to make camp in the woods off the trail as to avoid any random bandits and things. You're setting up a little campsite and you're digging a fire pit when, let's see, get a D4 out. I guess that's Marley then. You're digging along in the ground whenever you hit something hard.
Is it the Everest penis? I'm waiting for it.
What am I supposed to do?
I don't know. You hit an object while you're digging. What do you typically do?
Dig it out.
There you go. Okay.
I thought for sure she was about to say just ignore it and pretend it didn't happen.
I'd allow it.
Just keep shoveling.
As you begin digging around it, you notice that it's a small box. And you start digging it out. You manage to unwedge it from some roots that's been trapped there. You can tell that it's been there for a very long time.
Oh, God. No, you're not going to do what I think you're going to do.
I'm gonna open it.
Oh no, oh god.
I'm gonna.
Why are you guys afraid of loot?
No, no.
I'm opening it. Fuck it. But I didn't like the look that he got when I said I'm gonna open it. I like how the background music is just Skyrim music.
Roll a d12.
Oh no. Well, if I don't drop it first.
There we go. I only make art.
Oh, I rolled a 1.
A 1?
You only make art?
Yeah. Okay. That's actually the best thing you could have rolled.
Really?
Yeah, it's not particularly for you, for your class, but it's still the best thing that was on this roll table. Go ahead and add this to either, you can either add this to your loot or to party loot. It's a +1 wand of the War Mage.
Ooh.
It gives you a +1 to attack with spell attacks when using spells and holding the wand. And you ignore half cover when making a spell attack.
Does that count towards cantrips?
Yeah, as long as it has a spell attack, but you have to be holding the wand, so.
I'll keep it. What's it called again?
+1 wand of the War Mage. It's pretty much a fucking, like a Harry Potter wand. Just a little wand.
You know what the silliest thing is that's actually, that, is it made of wood?
I can roll for that.
Well, if it's made out of wood, it's technically a candidate for shillelagh.
Well, let's roll.
And you could use it as a club.
That is an important question in her case.
True.
Because if you can't use it for shillelagh, I don't think that your other one uses attack rolls, so it wouldn't do anything for you.
It is made of wood.
Hell yeah.
So yeah, you could slap people with it using shillelagh, which is retarded, but it'll work.
Keep your hands off my shillelagh.
You're just bonking people with a fucking stick. Okay. So you guys, what the hell?
I gotta admire the dedication, man.
And it's gone.
Okay, so you guys have made camp, you do the camp, it's all good. Now, okay. Ryan.
Yes.
Halfway through the trip, you run out of food. What do you do?
I'm gonna go hunt for the biggest creature I can find, so I can roast it in a goat pit.
Okay.
Alright, what do I need to do here? I'm gonna attempt to find the biggest creature that I could theoretically kill, cook, and eat.
That's a dangerous question.
Okay, I'm gonna need you to roll a survival check for hunting.
Survival check, okay. I got a 3.
You managed to find a small berry bush.
Small berry bush. Well, I guess I'm going to pick what I can off of it.
Alright, you pick a small handful of berries off this bush.
That's my supper tonight.
I can split my rations.
Yeah, I was going to say, I can share rations. I'm not afraid to.
I've still got 4 weeks.
I'm going to tornado watch.
Alright, Ryan, whenever you make it back from the woods with your nature's bounty, you sit down and look upon these small red berries in your hand while the other people are sitting around eating dried meats and breads.
Am I about to shit myself to death?
You
get this dairy.
You decide that you need to make this last a little bit, so you're just eating one berry at a time while you guys regale stories. And a few.
Can I cook? Can I roast the berries before I eat them? I just like cook them. Turn my shield upside down since it's metal and use it as a bowl and just cook the berries in it.
You're gonna walk your berries?
I'm gonna walk my berries.
Yeah, sure. You can walk your berries.
I'm gonna turn my berries.
You know that'll like caramelize the sugars and shit. It'll probably be more like brittle than anything.
That's fine. If it's tougher, it'll keep me from eating it as fast.
Okay. Your party looks at you in confusion as you,
Can I add some of the dried meats to it?
As you do this.
Yeah.
And you just, you look down upon your now darkened brown sugar brittle.
Perfect.
Or a slight red tint.
Just like Mama used to make.
I hand him a piece of bread.
The elasticity of it's a little unsavory, but you begin eating this strange sugary brittle. It doesn't taste too bad, but
that's something
you,
at least.
You go about your business eating it. whenever you awaken the next morning, you found that you've shat your armor, and you fell.
Wait, who sleeps in their armor?
Well, you do if you're on an adventure propped up against a tree. I mean, unless you want to remove your armor, you'll just shit your pants regardless.
Nah, it's fine. I'll shit my armor.
Okay, you shit your armor.
I'll wash off in the river or something.
Fine. Tyler.
Yo.
Do it.
What am I doing?
Play the video.
Oh. Crap, I don't have it queued up.
Damn it.
I don't even know the command.
Just use the other bot.
I'm going to.
Are you shitting your shell?
Well, that happened.
I love how the music paused for that. okay, so yeah, you've gotten the shit washed off. You've had a pretty rough day in that little camping time.
Wait,
beautiful.
Wait. There we go.
Yeah, pretty much. You notice that you're not really getting any better either. You know that whenever you make it to the loop port, you're probably going to need to go see a doctor.
Beautiful.
Can I do have lesser restoration.
You do have lesser restoration?
Yes.
It's you can cast that on him.
Yeah, sure. I'll get the spell back by the time I get there right there.
Huh?
You didn't give me my cantrip.
That's not on that. You'll have to add your spells. I didn't add those for you because they weren't on that other thing.
Alright, yeah.
I'll do it later.
I'll cast the restoration on him.
Okay.
Thank you. Well, you've saved my butthole.
Can I also cast Sacred Flame to see if I can just
light a fart on fire? No, you're gonna need to calm down. Alright, Ryan. I'm gonna have you roll a few more times to see if you can make it through this last week of travel. Give me two more survival checks.
Alright.
We that both offered to give him food.
That is a 5 and an 11.
Well, you learned your lesson last time about the
berries.
About the berries on that first roll. On the second one, you've managed to find a few rabbits and small foxes to eat. Do you want to try to skin them?
I mean, I'm not just going to eat the skin.
Well, I get that, but are you going to waste it, or are you going to try to skin them and get it prepped for sale?
I mean, I might as well if we're going to be traveling anyway.
All right.
I mean, the horse is carrying the cart.
Give me one more survival check, then, for skinning.
That is a 16.
There you go. You perfectly skinned these fucking things. Go ahead and add 3 fox skins and 5 rabbit skins to your, shit.
Actually, I probably should. I have a +5 to survival.
That's why I'd say you don't have to always just over-purchase when it comes to travel food. You can hunt, for the most part, if you've got people with good survival bonuses.
Yeah.
I don't, but, you know. Got lucky.
Sort of.
I'm gonna regain my spell slot.
Oh, and you can add a recipe to your character now, Ryan. You'll call it Shittle.
Shittle?
Shittle.
Yeah.
Shittles.
It's a Shih Tzu.
No, they're Shittles. They're chewy, fucking fruit-flavored things that make you shit yourself.
Yeah. It's like Skittles made of lycosin.
Fiber!
They're like Haribo sugar-free gummy bears.
But Skittles.
That should there be a fan.
With built-in lycosin.
Yeah, that's
I'm not
what
adding
this for.
On my character.
Yeah, that was a joke regardless, but you still know what those little red berries are now.
It's burned into his memory.
Literally.
Into the asshole.
Actually, if we come back through here, I might pick some more just in case I make enemies with someone to the point where I don't want them dead, but I want them inconvenienced.
you've really burned my brisket. I'm gonna make you poop your pants.
It's kind of like whenever people put like a single eye drop in someone's coffee.
Oh god. Give them the screaming grease shits for the next 2 days. Okay, so you eventually make it to Loopport. The town that you come upon, the direction that you're coming from, you go through just miles of fucking fields. The plants there grow like fucking crazy from the riverbed nearby, giving it nutrients. You see the farmers out in the field. They wave at you as you're coming into town and stare kind of cockheadedly at your Olympic horse.
Leave Abracadabra alone.
Abracadabra.
This horse is now as much of a party member as we are.
It is.
The horse is honestly pretty memorable.
Oh yeah.
Africa, fuck you.
Alright.
I hope that we keep this horse all the way until the end of the campaign.
If it'll fucking survive.
It's our horse now. I'm gonna make sure it survives to the best of my ability. I admire its plucky attitude and its can-do spirit.
I'm gonna give it the Shadow of the Colossus treatment.
Oh, don't do that.
Alright, so you guys make it through these this long-ass fucking road, just nothing but fields. And you eventually make it onto some to some steps leading up to the town. The steps come to a... You know what? Wait a second. I can show you guys what I have done of Blueport so far so that you can see what the fuck I'm talking about. It's kind of hard to explain. Hurry up and load, you piece of shit. This is what I have done on Blueport so far. You guys are coming from the eastern side of all this. There's a road running through that large ass fucking field. And the part that you've come to is in this central section along the riverbank. These cliffs kind of come up to a large castle wall type, it's kind of like it's bastioned in between all this to protect the town up on top of a hill. There is a cart ramp for you guys to take in the middle of the steps so you guys can get your horse to hobble its way on up and take you into the center of town. This big central section that I've got kind of placed, it's not finalized obviously, but is the trading district. So that's pretty much where you'll end up in the beginning.
Okay. Alrighty.
Okay, so there's you guys at Blueport. It is a bustling trade city.
This place looks like Pittsburgh.
Looks like
Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh.
It's got the same kind of, like, structural, it looks like Vicksburg. Just take my word for it.
Alright. Oh, I should mention, if you probably noticed, that there's a river going underneath it. The city's, like, central area where the trade is actually built on top of the river and over it. So, like, none of the land there is natural. It's just a big-ass fucking man-made island in the middle of all that bullshit there, connected together with castle infrastructure.
Is the map updated? Like, are y'all seeing something? Because I'm still on the big map.
It's on Discord. It took me a minute to, yeah.
Okay.
We plop up on in there. And I guess we look for Dave's contacts.
Yeah, whenever you guys get into town, you'll get waved down by a guy sitting at the benches at that fucking statue fountain in the center. He kind of flags you guys down. And he said, "I was told to look out for a horse with a gimpy leg."
I told you to look out for it.
Pardon my intrusion. I am an advocate for the House of Burn.
Alright. Well,
And your name?
That is unimportant.
Oh, but it is.
He's a kind of squirrely looking man wearing just regular commoner's clothes and a dusty fucking
a dusty duster.
No, not a dusty duster, but he is wearing a dingy old noble's cap that's just dirt ridden and brown and just nasty looking, kind of cut up, stitches running through it and all that.
Alright, did we learn the name of the sea hag that we're looking for?
No, you just know that there's a sea hag in this area that has the answers to where to go to fix the problem.
Let's ask if he knows anything about where we might go next to find to see the sea hag, if he knows where it is.
He says, yes, we'll discuss all that whenever we get inside. And he motions you guys towards a tavern nearby.
Okay. I will follow him.
I don't trust him.
He walks along to a tavern. It's got the saloon-style swinging front.
I don't trust him at all.
You notice it's kind of a ritzy place. It's not like your usual tavern back in Rivers Rock. It's much nicer in there.
I mean, I'm going in.
All right.
I'm going in.
When you make it inside, you just kind of feel slightly deafened from the noise and hustle and bustle from the trade city outside. The quiet in here is definitely welcome in comparison to the outside after your long trip. You were not ready for all that aggravation. But you get seated down at a table with him, and he waves his hands over, and they start bringing out food for you guys to eat and set it down at the tables. He says, "All right, I'm supposed to tell you what now?" You said you needed something from me? Some information? I was just supposed to help you.
Anybody gonna take the lead on this?
You don't know. Let's see. I'm going through my notes. Hang on. Child. Let's see. She was unable to be ready to. Okay.
I might order a drink.
Told the party that a.
There's drinks there.
I'm gonna get a drink.
Okay. You start drinking.
Are there options?
You can get ales, wines, whatever you want.
I'm gonna drink an ale.
However.
Drink an ale. Give me con save.
We won't get this information freely or willy.
Let's see how good you're doing. Four.
Oh no.
For a con save modifier.
Wait, there you go. I don't
you don't make it. You start drinking. You start drinking the ale, and before you know it, you've had three, and you're just kind of leaned over on Curtis's shell, just having a damn good time.
Alright, I'm gonna ask him what was he told to do when we got here.
So, well, The Burns butler made it very clear that I was supposed to help you in your endeavors. He said something about you killing a hag, and I was supposed to make sure you guys were comfortable while you were staying in town.
We're definitely looking for a hag. Do you have any information on where she might be?
You guys already know where it's at.
Oh, well, never mind then.
The witch pointed it out on your map where the cave was.
Well, never mind then.
Okay, well, let's...
Ask Curtis. Can I ride on his shelf?
I'm gonna put on my shiny new leash and get up down like a turtle.
We're not doing this right now, goddammit.
Oh my god.
Well, I didn't mean it like that.
Alright, these two have started acting stupid in the tavern, so one of you two are gonna have to take over for vocal lead right now.
No,
the butler is looking at you guys.
She's just
completely,
I guess,
distraught that you guys are supposed to be the saviors.
She wants to.
The house of burn. He feels that the house will burn in hellfire, and no one will be able to save it if this is all that we can afford.
I smile at him.
Like,
yeah, he's about right.
Don't worry about them. They're just a little stir crazy from being on the road too long.
He says, surely and undoubtedly. Cock shocker 4200, okay.
he metagames and sees your name and he just leaves the tavern. It's like, nope,
okay,
nope, fuck this, we're done, we're out.
Okay,
what are these shocking abilities you speak of?
Oh, Ryan, one thing you probably didn't notice. But if you look in your journal, I have an updated thing on your spear.
I did see that, actually.
And... Yeah, so yeah, I thought you'd like that. It has some stuff that you can't see on there that will...
Open up as
later.
I add more
souls to the soul jar. Yeah,
makes sense.
All right.
How long does my drunkenness last?
For a few hours, probably. A
couple hours. Okay, so he is gonna pretty much just take the lead here and explain that you guys are gonna be staying in this tavern. He hands you guys 4 room keys. You each get your own personal room.
Yeah, that's what.
And
that's what.
Anytime that you stay in town in this tavern at night, you'll be fed. So it's pretty much your free food stop while you're here.
Yeah, I was just gonna say, let's rest up and then head to the cave in the morning.
That's good to me.
He says, "Now you said that you had not you, but the butler said that." You knew where this hag was?
Yeah, she has like a underwater cavern sort of lair. That's what we were told.
He says, right. I'll have my scouts go check it out, and he asks to see your map to show him where it's supposed to be.
Okay.
Can we name this guy Preston?
I don't know that I like that.
Yeah, he's going to mark it on our map.
Well, no, he said that he wants to see our map so he can send people to go look at it.
Yeah, he's going to send scouts.
I can follow our reference, Curtis.
He doesn't trust us to do this. I don't know that he's not going to fuck this up. If he sends scouts out there and they get discovered, she's going to be on high alert.
To be fair, hags are always on high alert.
Yeah, but at this current time, she doesn't know that anyone's going to be coming after her.
I imagine that the scouts are probably all going to die anyway. But I don't know.
I mean, it's up to y'all. I don't know that I like him sending scouts.
Yeah, let's... Okay, we'll,
Just as a tactical thing.
So you tell him no?
I'll ask the party's opinion on that, and since Curtis is currently being a turtle on a leash, I will really just be asking Tyler this.
No, that's fine. We'll get down to matter.
Inebriated.
Yeah. I really don't
care either way.
Yeah. If he can spare
people, have the people go with us rather than before us.
Yeah.
I'm okay with that.
Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
He says, oh, I had no intention on sending people as scouts.
What do you mean?
Explain.
He raises his hand from the table and he snaps his fingers, and whatever he does, shadows wisp around his hands and eventually explode into a raven atop his finger.
Okay, well, never mind. That's a little different. Yeah, okay. Here's the map.
Okay. He points his bird to the map. He finds your little marker for it, and the bird looks at it, cocks its head, and then vanishes into shadow.
All right.
While we're sitting here talking to him, I'm going to ask him who would be the best to charter to carry us out into the middle of the lake.
He says, well, the Burns have already got a boat here in town if you just want to use that, so.
Oh, very well then.
Alright. Well, what time is it?
So Marley doesn't have to worry about breathing underwater, and we have one potion of water breathing.
I can...
No, we each got potions.
Oh, we each did.
Yes.
Yeah, there are four potions of water breathing.
Never mind.
I'm a turtle, so I don't care.
I retract my previous statement.
I can hold my breath for 60 minutes.
Oh, well, yeah, in this case, it's just two of us that really need.
Yep.
Alright, yeah, I mean...
And we'll have extra potions if they need them.
Yeah. If it's like daytime stuff, let's go ahead and head out there. Or y'all want to rest?
Probably rest and then head out tomorrow.
He says, "Wonderful, wonderful. You guys can find your rooms upstairs." And he then says, "I'm going to go to my personal quarters now. It's been a long, long day. I've been sitting out there on that bench since, well, a day ago."
I'm going to actually thank him for his time. I'm going to kind of set Marley off to the side and she can do her own thing.
Cut out real bad.
I'm gonna thank him for his time.
Oh, okay.
He gives you a bow and how do you do, and he turns around and walks off.
Alright.
He doesn't get to stay in the nice tavern.
Poor guy.
I kind of wanted to say something, but I'm not sure if you'd actually get the reference, Justin. Pour me a drink, bartender.
I don't get it, nope.
Nah, okay, never mind. Alright.
Okay. So you guys are just going to rust up. Marley, you're no longer drunk.
Hey, more drinks.
So you spend your night getting piss wasted, then.
She's kind of...
Yeah.
Alright.
Incredible.
Okay, all of you wake up feeling well-rested except Marley. She wakes up in a puddle of her own urine in the floor of her room.
Am I gonna have to do like a fucking check on my shell to make sure I don't have piss on me?
No, you knew to get the fuck away from that whenever she tried to use you as a mechanical bull. So, yeah.
Damn.
All of you well rested. Marley covered in urine. Horrible headache.
Is Tyler still shit himself or did he clean his clothes?
Ryan, he can take care of his shit. Oh my god, calm down. It was just thunder. Fuck you, thunder. You can suck our dicks, remember?
Okay.
Alright, to the boat.
Fuck you, Thunder. You can suck our dicks. Okay, remember. What?
No, I'm talking to the dog.
Yeah.
She freaks out during thunderstorms.
I see.
It's not gonna get you. We're inside. Okay, so what are you guys gonna do? You are now awake. I'm sure Marley's gonna clean herself first.
I guess just go to where that boat is.
Let's head to the boat.
Alright.
Wait. I need to find it. Hang on. Okay, how do I play music? What's the thing to play music?
It's either hyphen play or underscore play. If you're talking about the bot.
Yes.
Either one.
Alright, we are, we're getting on the boat.
Well, you guys are headed to the boat. You haven't gone anywhere yet.
Okay.
Go to the boat.
Yeah.
Do underscore players.
I did. You can continue.
Why is Curtis cutting out so much?
I don't know. I think it's the sensitivity. Okay, so you guys start heading out. And, whenever you get outside of the tavern, you see, as Curtis wants to call him, Preston.
Preston.
Sitting on that same bench where he called you guys before. He looks over your way and immediately jumps up to attention and says, "Hello, hello, I have news."
Okay. What's the news?
He said, "My pretty, pretty little bird went around and scouting this area that the hag is supposed to be in. And it has told me many a thing, many a strange thing."
Continue.
He says, "The only things that come and go from the cave are goblins. Very strange. Goblins are not normally ones to seek water refuge, so there's no telling what you may find there. However, all of the goblins that come and go from that place have come and gone with a password, spoken in a language that I don't know, and they were carrying an amulet every time that they came in. The amulet seemed to glow as they were walking through."
Yeah, that's definitely her cup of tea. Because she knows like six languages.
So what did your bird follow to see where the goblins went when they left the cave?
Oh, they were mostly just gathering supplies, it seems. There were a few people killed outside of town. They stole from them. Killed a few fish.
I think we should find this this group of goblins whenever they leave the cave again and steal an amulet from them.
Yeah, see if we can figure out the password. Maybe we could just talk to them. Maybe they, well, I don't know. We could try talking to them. And
so where were the goblins last seen then?
Right. Well, this right there by the cave.
Oh.
Just northwest of Mortarmon.
Alright, let's see if we can go hunt him down then.
Alright, let's do it.
He kind of motions you forth in a haphazard flail and trances off to the south of Loopport. If you look at the Loopport map, you'll see that there is a dock area down there with a small trade market.
Yeah.
You guys will be hitching a ride on one of those boats.
Alright.
Alright. You get up on the boat. The captain there looks each of you over as you get on and kind of gives Ryan a nod as he walks through. He can tell that you're a soldier. He gave you a...
Oh, okay. Okay, so like a what's up nod.
Yeah, you know.
Okay. That,
you know.
I was trying to figure out if I was supposed to know this guy. But okay.
No, it was one of those word around the offices, you got a fat cock kind of deal.
Okay, yeah, I'll nod back. Respect.
Alright, you guys get on the boat and sail off into the sea.
I don't know why, I just thought that was funny.
Jesus Christ. The captain immediately leaves his cabin and throws the minstrel off the deck.
Okay.
The captain ties the rope around his ankle and then throws the anchor overboard.
He walks over, he breaks the accordion, picks the man up, and throws him over the deck. Too loud. Why does it never just play the fucking thing that I wanted to play? There you go. The Wilhelm scream is applied. With a nice as he hits the water. Okay.
I nudged Tyler. I was like, hey! Can you believe I paid that guy to do that shit?
Okay, so you guys are at sea for, you guys are at sea for roughly 5 days whenever you come up to the edge of this little island. They give you a paddle boat and lower you down to the water and give you a salute as you leave.
I give them a sailor salute.
Alright. Oh yeah, I forgot you were a pirate. You get the nod too. Well, not a pirate, but a sailor. You get the nod too.
Imagine he gets a bigger nod.
Well, he doesn't know for sure that he's a sailor at the beginning, unless he were to go talk to him, but the way that they carry themselves is a bit different. He wouldn't have gotten the sea wobbles at all.
I think it's some sea gobbles, let me tell you about that.
Okay, kabobbles. No, you are not kabobbles, Google Home.
Oh my god.
See, even Google agrees with us.
Okay, you piece of shit. Oh, you don't respond to that, huh? Okay, dipshit. Oh, that doesn't seem to work. Oh,
I'll be
okay.
Right back.
Hey, fuckhead.
Yes.
I said I'd be right back.
Hey, scrotum.
Who?
See, you don't respond to any of that. Why do you respond to hey, kabobbles? Oh, no, you're not going to. Yeah, again. Fuck you, Google Home.
Good?
Yeah, I feel better.
Okay.
That fucking Google Home pisses me off. The stupid piece of shit. I have to say sentences backwards for it to fucking understand me half the time.
Listening to you try to get it to play a song What song were you trying to play the other day?
I was trying to get it to play the fucking Weeknd, alright? The Weeknd by Motion City soundtrack. I said, you know what I say to make it start. I'm not even going to get it fucking started. I said the activation. And then I said, oh god, what the fuck is that? I'm hearing it through Marley because I'm talking loud, I guess. I don't know. But I said the activation thing, and then I said, play The Weeknd by Motion City soundtrack, and it started playing some random bullshit like 8 fucking times. I had to say, play Motion City soundtrack, The Weeknd, before it would get it. It's the same goddamn sentence with the same fucking words. Why did it get totally different songs and bands?
I mean, it didn't even work after that, remember? It took you like 2 times of saying that to get it to be right.
It's just the fact that it's the same words. They're just in reverse order. This fucking Google Home hates me. Fuck you. Yeah. Fuck you, Google.
Are you still fighting with that thing?
Just listen. Listen to this shit. Fuck you, Google. Oh, I didn't do it that time. Fuck you, Google. Yeah, see? Piece of shit. It's trying to fuck with me now.
See, you need a Google Bliat, not a Google Home.
Dude, if I had a Google Bliat, I'd be happy.
Alright,
so you guys are on a paddle boat.
Are we going fast, man?
You have 2 wars and a dream. I need you to go directions.
Alright.
Go left.
I go
Twitch
right.
Twitch plays paddle boat.
Fuck no, let's just go to the fucking island. Alright,
okay, so you paddle your way up to the island, and you're roughly where the cave should be, just the cave is underwater.
So, I know I had that one plan earlier, but I'd like to amend the plan.
Okay.
Instead of approaching the goblins, let's wait for them to go ahead and say the word to get in, and then ambush them.
Yeah, I was gonna
say.
That
way the door's already open, and we don't have to figure out the password.
Maybe. And we don't know if the goblins are hostile or not.
I'm sure they are.
Well, let's try. Well, we're trying to get information out of the sea hag, but...
Well, I mean, we could try and sneak our way in, and if they don't like it, then that's on them. Because we need in either way.
Yeah, we could try to scope out and see if they open the cave door.
Okay. You guys set up a thing. What was it called?
Stakeout.
Yeah, stakeout. Problem is it's like underwater. Way down underwater. You can look for ones that are swimming atop and then go down afterwards, but the deal is the only person that can really stay underwater for an unlimited amount of time is probably Marley with her gills.
Does each person that enters have to have an amulet, or is it just it opens the door with an amulet for a certain amount of time?
You don't know.
That's fair.
I could swim down there and just see. Just kind of like swim away from it so I can see like what's going on down there. And just come up for air every...
Hour.
It'd probably be wise for me and Ryan to save our potions.
Mm-hmm.
How long do the potions last?
I want to say those things last an hour.
And then me and Ryan have 2 apiece since they're not going to use theirs.
Let's see.
I'm looking it up now.
Yeah, 1 hour.
Yeah.
Alright, I'll go dive below and scope out the cave entrance.
Okay. you dive down into the water. You notice something strange, you being an aquatic creature, you know a bit about water. The foliage, as you break the water down below at the bottom of the sea here, is very different from what it should be in the sea. It looks more like an ocean inside when it comes to plants and wildlife that are swimming around. It's a little strange. You notice even coral has started forming down at the bottom of the sea.
So is water pressure a thing? If I like swim down too far, I'll get crushed by it.
But you're in a lake. It's not gonna be that extreme.
It's an inland sea, but yeah, you're not gonna get low enough to get destroyed by the water pressure here.
Yeah, okay. I will swim away from the cave entrance. Is there like anywhere I can hide, like by the cave entrance?
Yeah, you can hang out in some of the kelp and coral and shit that are around in the area.
Alright, let's try it.
Okay. You hang out. You see a lot of fish and shit swimming around, and you've had to come up and down a couple of times, but eventually You see a goblin leaving out of the cave.
Okay. I'm going.
He just kind of freely swims past the entrance.
So he's coming out.
Yep.
All right. I want to follow him, or come back up, keeping an eye on him, and tell them. Or will that alert him? That'll probably alert him. Fuck. Yeah, I'm gonna hang back and try to follow him.
Oh, something I should note, this cave has some large column-like structures around it. It looks like a big archway. Okay, so you follow him. He pretty much comes out of the cave, swims around to the right, and then starts going straight up towards the surface.
Okay. I shall very quietly break the surface of the water.
Alright, your little turtle head pops up.
I'm gonna kind of hold my hand open and kind of wave for the other guys if I can without making too much noise.
Alright. You guys, you see Curtis kind of wave you down.
And then I'm gonna kind of like do a pointing. So they kind of get the mark.
Start paddling slowly toward Curtis, I guess. Or towards where he's pointing.
Alright, the goblin eventually makes it up to the shore. You're a little bit faster swimmer than him, for sure. He makes it up to the shore, kind of reaches the top, gasping for air. You notice he didn't exactly have a potion on him. And, he starts walking along the shoreline.
Like on the island itself?
Yeah.
Alright, let's see. How do I want to approach this? Does anything seem off about the goblin that I can tell?
No, it just looks like your average everyday goblin.
Alright, I'm going to approach him.
You're just going to approach him? Like, just walk up to him?
I'm debating if I want to.
Uh. You doing this stealthily? Or nah?
Fuck, I don't know. You know, I could just try to grapple him. Just dive his ass. What do you guys think I should do?
I mean, either way, we get an answer of some sort, because if he's hostile to you, then we know that he's just immediately going to be hostile. Which means we don't have to feel bad about ambushing him or his other guys. On the other hand, we do lose the element of surprise. So, it's up to you. I mean, either way works.
Well, it's just him.
If we approach him right now, we just lose the element of surprise on him.
Yeah.
They know he's gone. I mean.
Yeah.
That's true.
Alright, I'm just going to walk up to him.
Okay. Whenever he hears footsteps behind him, he immediately jumps back away from you and draws two daggers. They're kind of crudely made out of undersea shells and things that are found in the area, like shark's teeth. He jumps back, grabs them, pulls them out of their sheaths, and gives you a dark glare as he looks upon your crew. He looks around and sees that he's outnumbered, and he says, What do you want?
We need to get into that cave, so I'm going to give you a choice. We need to talk to the sea hag that's down there. I'm sure you probably don't want to die.
You'd be wrong. No.
Motherfucker, that's all I've wanted since day one. Bring it on.
I said we need an amulet and we need a password.
He says, even if you were to kill me and take my amulet, even if you did beat the password out of me, you'll never get past that door.
Why not?
The barrier. It protects her. It protects all of us.
You know how funny it would be if, like, we just walked up through it and just walked through anyway?
What's the barrier?
I'm not a wizard. I'm a stabby stab. I stab things.
So
I don't cast the hullabuts.
So how do you get past the barrier then?
How do you know that we can't get past it if you don't understand how it works?
Others have tried, others have died.
Yeah, but they weren't us.
He kind of looks at you confusedly.
Have you ever seen retards of this caliber?
It's like...
You fucking stupid.
Oh, I'm giving you a chance to walk away with your life, but you're going to tell us how we're going to get past this barrier.
He says, if I could tell you how to get past it, I would. Goblins value nothing more than their own life. All I know is that these amulets have our names written on the back of them in some strange code.
Can I look at the amulet?
He puts away one of his daggers and reaches behind his neck, unclasps the amulet, and throws it to you.
Okay.
Thanks, we'll be taking this.
Does anybody know, like, the symbols or anything on it? Would any of us know it?
I mean, the only special language I know is if thieves can't, I doubt it would be that.
Well,
is it some kind of code?
I know Elvish as well, but I doubt it's that too.
I might know it.
Okay. I'm going to try to show it to... where is it? Plasma? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, you see the amulet. It is a... it's an opal amulet. and it's bound in silver, and on the underside of it is his name written in Sylvan.
I know Sylvan.
But the letter work on it is what's runed. Even though it's written in Sylvan, the strokes are not strokes. It's individual runes made into the name.
Can we seek an audience with them? Because we're not looking to kill the Sea Hag. We just need answers.
I doubt it.
Well, shit.
Could you check?
I'm not even allowed in your room.
But you can go in. Can we borrow your amulet?
You can have the damn thing if it'll make you leave me alone.
Cool, thanks. Get out.
He draws his other dagger and just kind of backward steps away from you guys.
Did he ever give us the password? Because we kind of need that too.
Well, it doesn't seem like it matters. But we can't get through it. Well, he probably doesn't know how to get an amulet tailored to us, does he? He's
I'm
just a goblin.
The hag gives it to him.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, you could always ask him.
Yeah.
Where did you get this amulet?
Do you know if we could get an amulet like this?
He says, there is a visitor who comes to make our amulets when we need them. One more brood is spawned.
So if you're just willing to give all this up this easily, why are you all living there?
Well, he's not. We're threatening his life.
Goblins are extremely, like, self-centered. They don't give a fuck about anyone but themselves.
But what I don't understand is why they're even working for the hag to begin with.
What else do they have to do?
That's what
the hag gives them power and numbers and the ability to spawn more brood without getting killed.
If there was
more goblins here than there was you, he would have never even considered it, so that's just goblin nature.
Yeah, I was thinking mind control, but I don't know.
When's your next hatch of brood supposed to spawn? I don't know.
Hatch of brood.
I said what I said.
Jesus Christ. Oh my god.
Next clutch.
Holy hell, they're not spiders.
They can be if you want them to be. Time to be older.
Oh, Jesus Christ. He says, I don't know. I don't know. Don't kill me for not knowing. I don't know.
It sounds like you want me to kill you.
Fuck.
He says, but I can tell you. I can tell you who the visitor is, if that'll make you leave me the hell alone.
Alright, who is it?
She's a green witch from the woods north of Luport.
So
she inscribes the runes, she protects us, that's all I know. Don't kill me.
Okay.
And is that your name, buddy? Is your name Don't Kill Me?
It is if it'll make you not. And he just takes a few more steps backwards.
Alright, I'm gonna let him go. I think we've got a good solid lead at least. We could go to this witch. Where's, can I call him Garvey and see if he'll mark this on the map?
Oh, he's not gonna let you get close to him.
Can I try and sneak around behind him and put a blade up to his throat just to scare him?
Well, he sees you, so it'd be kind of hard to.
Shit.
And you're,
I work you in magical ways.
Yeah, I mean, have all you right. ever seen retards of this caliber before? Like,
all right, let's go.
He
to
might
the
have
switch.
Object. He might have object permanent issues where it's if you play peekaboo, he'll forget you're there.
Yeah, if he doesn't see you, you don't exist.
Yeah.
Well, that's kind of rude, just leaving in the middle of a conversation.
How do
you keep doing
that? I want to be the dungeon master. God, I want to see what happens.
That's the main reason why I wanted to start mine, because I just want to see what the fuck happens. Alright, so I vote let's go to the witch, whatever. Yeah. He's been a lot more helpful.
As you guys turn away back to your boat, you hear an incredibly quick shuffling noise behind you. You turn around and all you see is sand, dust in the air, and just a goblin running at high speeds.
After us or
no.
away.
Because he can't get back there.
Yeah, you guys stole his amulet.
Alright, let's go.
What
to
was his name?
You don't know, you didn't ask.
Let me in.
Actually, Marley can read it, can't she?
Oh, yeah. I read it.
His name is Giz.
Okay.
That's a good goblin name.
Sure it is.
We're off to see the wizard.
Wonderful witch
the wonderful witch of the woods. Alright, so I guess we need to take our boat back to land. I can't even play the fucking accordion song because some jack off decided to throw my accordion over the shoulder.
Sit down.
There you go.
Why'd you spell Deborah like that? That's not what we named her.
What's her name?
Abracadabra.
Hold on, you tell me how you want it spelled.
As long as you get the Abra part right, I don't care.
A-B-R-I.
Here
space
K-A. There's an abracadabra.
Thank you.
There we go.
That's what I wanted.
Bruh.
Abracadabra.
What are you feeding her? Oh, Lord. You gave the dog lime salt. Pickle salt?
It's pickle.
Dear Lord. She did not look happy about that. Okay, so you guys got that information. The goblin has ran to shit.
Yeah, we're getting
this now in your journals.
We're getting to the boat and gonna attempt to go find this green witch.
Okay.
Here you go, babe.
You guys paddle back and no, I'm good.
Try it.
I don't want it. And make it back to the boat. They shove off and head back to Loopport. You guys can decide whether or not you're going to share the information with the top hat wearing individual or not.
I don't trust anyone wearing a top hat.
We could see if he knows any information, but we don't have to show him the amulet. Just ask him about a witch in the woods.
Ask him if someone was breaking his butt.
He says he doesn't, but he can get a man on it.
A man or a bird?
He says probably the latter.
Okay.
Alright, that'll work.
Okay. He waits until you get back to Loopport. But he does his finger snappy, and his bird appears yet again and flies off to the north.
What's the bird's name?
I'm not doing this.
What's the bird's name?
No one cares. It doesn't have a name. It is a familiar. It doesn't need a name.
What if we need to dispel it?
Man, you really didn't think this through, Justin.
Just
Abrica, fuck yourself.
I really wish that Massachusetts state bird was the middle finger. I know I've said that before, but I really do.
Just imagine a flag that's just a middle finger and it's just...
So are we back in town and going to the forest to see the witch? Is that what we're doing?
That's what I would say. Once he gets his bird back and we find a location.
There you go. There's Preston now.
Oh my god.
Now you just need to put a picture in the bio for him and it's just fucking Preston to call it for. He marked it on our map.
He's gonna be the map.
Settlement
guy.
Needs our help. Where's his laser rifle?
Thank you, Ryan.
What?
I think he may have read Preston's bio.
Yeah, I did. I know exactly what happened.
That's that. All right, Justin. Can I roll a d6?
I'm exempt from that.
Your character has male sides too.
I was gonna say you're a changeling. No, you're not.
It just means that your ovaries could be shorter.
I can choose
shorter.
How big I want it. I can choose how big it is. So.
Yeah, but your ovaries could be smaller.
That doesn't matter.
You will produce 60% less eggs than the common female.
Good, 60% less periods.
60% happy eggs.
It is.
Oh god, like
it's not that you have less eggs, it's that the eggs are
eggs
smaller.
Are bigger.
So does that mean that fucking menopause is just vaginal dry heaving?
Pretty much.
Well, that happened.
I know Tyler's all thinking. Right. Tyler's picture that shit hard. Or soft, maybe the case, I don't know.
Definitely soft.
Oh.
It's like introverted now, it's inside.
Better than...
I have the ovaries now.
Look at me, I'm the ovaries now.
Okay, so you guys make it back to Loopport. Safe and sound, no monsters try to murder you in the water.
What about the monsters?
Definitely not them.
The Monstars.
And this Preston guy says, I should have some news for you by morning at least.
Alright. Fast forward.
So you guys are just gonna rush for the map?
Sure.
Okay.
We were out at sea for like 10 hours total, so sure.
Okay. So you guys go back to your tavern.
Living the high life, eating good food that doesn't give me the shits.
You sit down at a table, and you start eating, having a good time.
What's the bartender's name?
And as you're sitting there, having your good time, all of you drinking and just feeling like things are going good for you, suddenly, all of your visions go black for about half a second. And whenever they come back to, there's a man sitting at your table with you.
Hey, how's it going?
I feel like some...
Hey!
Oh god, this fucker.
Oh god.
What'll it be, old chap?
You guys don't know him, remember?
I see him. That's like, hey, what's up, old chap? Oh, not at all.
He says, good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. What can I do for you?
Why can't I see anything about him?
Because you guys don't know anything about him. Yep, add stuff to that section.
I mean,
as you,
like, the picture was on there before me, and now it's not.
Let it disappear. Exit out of it.
There we go.
Okay. So he says good evening.
Good evening.
Do we know you?
He says no, but I know you, and I know your brother.
I pull out my backup knife. What do you know?
He says, well, and he pulls out a deck of cards. He goes, I know that raising a knife to me is a worse gamble than dealing with a demon. And he starts shuffling the cards in his hand.
Well, I've got no intention of making any deals with demons.
He goes, then surely you know not to point that thing in my direction.
I don't know a thing about you. I'm not too intimidated yet.
He says, that's good. I'm not here to intimidate you. I'm here to make a deal. And he slaps his hands on the table and he does that cross shuffle thing where they raise their thumbs and all the cards kind of shift into place.
Yeah.
And he slaps them together. And he starts...
If you know anything about me or my brother, then you'll know that he's the one that makes deals.
He says, well, I know quite a bit about your brother. And he tosses you a card. And he tosses himself a card. He tosses you a card. And he tosses himself a card. And he sets the cards back down on the table. And he pulls his hand up and he nods to you.
So what's this all about?
Are you gonna look at your cards?
No.
Oh, okay.
That motherfucker just appeared out of nowhere and is now throwing cards around on the table, obviously trying to bait me into playing a game with him.
I'm
strongly suspicious of anyone who just appears out of nowhere offering information.
Rightfully so.
He looks kind of annoyed but shrugs it off, and he takes his cards back and puts them back in the pile, reshuffles them, and puts them back in his coat pocket. Looking a little more annoyed, he starts talking. He says, well, I'm here to make a wager with you, one that I'm sure you'll be very interested in.
Let me hear your terms.
It's a simple wager. It's more of a favor, if you will.
If it's a favor, then it's not a wager. Tell me what you want done and what you'll give me for doing it.
He says, all things are wagers if you think about it. Every time you take a breath, it could be poison. Remembering that will keep you alive, sir. He says, where you'll be heading to next? I believe you're trying to deal with a witch.
Okay, go on.
He sees that he's right, and he kind of gives himself a mental pat on the back. You see visibly in his face. He says, oh, then I guess you and I can help each other out. Whenever you fight this witch, she will attempt to haggle for her life. She will attempt to give you something in return for that life, something you greatly desire. I want you to kill her.
Okay. Well, what are you offering? Because in that case, I'm going to need to weigh the options of what you're offering versus what she's offering.
The location of your brother.
Damn.
That's pretty big. What guarantee do I have that you'll give me that?
Says, I'm a man of my word. And he takes off his white glove. And he extends it out in your direction.
Oh. I'm gonna eye his hand.
Nothing inconsistent. It's just a hand.
Well, I still need to know what she's gonna offer me. I'm not just gonna say that I'm going to do this without knowing.
He says, I just know the woman that you're after. She's fought before, and she's wormed her way out with pretty little lies. Deals to keep herself moving, and I don't want her to live anymore.
Why do you want her dead so bad?
She owes something to my benefactor, and has yet to pay it.
I'll tell you what, we'll hear out her offer. And if it's not better than what you're offering, well, actually, I can't guarantee that because my teammates also have a word here. I'm a team player. What do you guys think?
I think we wait and hear her out, too.
There you have it. We'll see what she offers. If it's not better, then yeah, we'll kill her.
He says, a businessman then. I can admire that. I can respect it. He kind of gives your party a look over and gives a smile. Whips a,
I wanna just stick tongue out at him and go.
He whips a cigar out. Pops it in his mouth, lights it with a flame from the end of his fingertip, and says, this is fine. I think you'll see that my terms are to your liking in the end. You do have your blood to worry about, don't you?
That I do. So, we have a deal then. If we kill her, then we come back and you give me information.
Agreed. And he puts his hand out.
Oh no, we've been here before.
That's a contract.
It's okay. I said if. I'll shake it.
Okay. Whenever you shake his hand, you definitely feel that same feeling your brother felt. Like for an instant everything went black. He says, pleasure doing business with you. I would definitely love to hear from you soon.
I'm just gonna kind of eye his gloves and give him a nod.
He puts his white glove back on one finger at a time.
I wanna open the bag for text stuff near him. Like I'm messing with my
I don't think we want to piss this guy off.
And no, are you intentional?
Are you opening the bag near him?
I see what she's
not
pulling
like
I'm out.
My
I'm gonna step
are
up.
You though?
Yeah.
Okay. Whenever you do that, as he's eyeing you over, he looks at that and he says, just like mother used to make.
Oh god.
Huh.
He tips his hat and says, I'm sure I'll be seeing you soon. And he vanishes.
Now, what exactly was in my bag?
As stated before, whenever you look inside it, it is just... You see things moving, you see things bubbling, you're pretty sure you see things blinking and talking, but it's all a blur. It looks pixelated in your brain as you try to remember it. As if your body is trying to actively keep you from seeing that again. The only sound heard from the bag is like a bubbling, grotesque grinding noise. is like bone on bone and flesh on flesh, whatever the fuck mud on goddamn blood would sound like.
And I bought that from who? That lady in the town?
Yeah, the turtle bitch.
I thought I bought it from the other one.
You bought it from the turtles.
Why was he not phased?
Just like mother used to make. But yeah, he completely vanishes as if he was never there.
Listen, I don't trust that guy at all. I've been a guard for over 10 years. I don't trust him. That man's obviously some kind of mob boss or something.
I don't like him. He's too fancy.
The gloves don't
lie. That said, he does have information I want. I wouldn't normally make a deal with him, but I could really use that information.
Well, it sounds like we got a witch to visit.
Okay. Alright, so what are you guys gonna do now? You were in the middle of enjoying your evening before he appeared.
I'm gonna mentally block out the visions that I saw, and I'm gonna go to my room.
Alright.
What is there to do in the town?
In Lewport, there is... Well... God fucking... In Lewport, so far, you've got the, you got the dock section, which is mostly just trade and pubs. And you've got the trade section, which is all about trading. Go around buying shit, and then there's the row, which is that dark section to the east where all the poor people hang out.
Can we go, or can I go to the trading area?
You're already there.
I want to look for the weirdest thing, per usual.
Oh, dear lord. So you're gonna try to find a magic shop first, then, yeah? Or a curiosity shop of some sort.
Yeah, yeah.
I swear by the end of this, Marley is gonna end up with like Aubrey 2.0 or a six demon bag or some shit.
This is why you look for random shit. You find good stuff in between. Things that are completely useless but get a laugh.
Yeah, but remember what happened last time? You bought something goofy and then you really wanted that chicken foot later? You couldn't get it.
Take me to the shops. Lead me around. Come on, we don't have all day.
Apparently we do.
Yes, Mr. 20 years to look through the binder for something that you have typed on screen.
Uh-huh. You're the one going to a magic shop to find a useless item.
Useless? You don't even know what you're going to find.
Justin does, though.
Yeah, I'm like, literally, you just want to buy useless items because they're goofy and quirky.
Is that not the entire thing of my character?
I figured it was survival and trying to get yourself uncursed.
No! I'm oblivious to etiquette and social expectations.
That doesn't mean that you don't want to live.
I want things that are going to be fun. And that I can research.
Well, as this is a trade town, you won't find much in the way of random BS here.
Sure.
But you do happen upon a magic shop.
Put me in there.
Oh, you're there.
Alright, look around.
Jesus Christ. Why are you being a dick?
Because you are. I don't know. I want to walk up to the storekeep and be like, what's your weirdest thing that you've got?
Okay, as you walk into Lewport's back alley magic shop, because they don't like mages too much in these parts, whenever you walk into their little back alley magic shop, you come into contact with a gnome.
Wait, can I describe the item?
He's sitting there tinkering with a small glass orb, looking under a microscope.
I say hello.
He bites his lip really hard, working on his project. Sets down his tiny work equipment and looks at you. He's wearing those weird goggles that have the different layers of magnifying on them. And then he pulls those off and says, Oh, yes, what can I do for you?
I was looking for the weirdest item that you have in the shop.
Weirdest item? What do you mean?
The one thing that people look at and is like, I would never buy that.
Why?
Because.
I do have a pile of dysfunctional magic items you could buy.
Like what?
Says, well, this is, and he reaches down underneath and to what looks like a trash can, and he pulls up a rod. It's like a baton, like a beating stick that a cop would have, you know. He pulls up and you see it's got intricate designs and it looks nice, magical. There's no way that it could be shitty. He says, this right here was supposed to be a rod of returning. It didn't work out.
Oh, this music's no. kind of fitting.
Well, it's bad. It's real bad.
What did it do? I'm curious.
Whenever you throw a rod of returning, it's supposed to come back to your hand.
Oh. Where did it go?
I call this one now the Rod of Probing.
You're about to get molested. Get the fuck out.
If you buy this, do not throw it in town.
It probes the least
willing. Can I ask how much this is?
You're not even there.
Marley, if you get this, you have to trick one of the villains into trying to throw it.
How much is it?
Because, well, I'm trying to get my money back on the investment that I put into it, so if you can give me 25 gold, it's yours.
Oh my god.
That's a steal, bro.
I'll take your entire stock.
Yeah, it's fun.
Oh man, you could have haggled him down. You could have been like, look, no one's ever going to buy this. You might as well cut your losses.
He could have found somebody. You can put that thing in a Saw movie trap.
What's 111 minus 24?
Or a Pornhub video.
Just use your calculator.
Hey Google, what's 111 minus 25?
86.
Thank you.
Four.
What else do you have in that pile?
Oh man. He reaches down into the thing yet again, and he pulls out something else. He goes, are you sure about this? These are strange items.
Yes.
It's a piece of paper that whenever you mark on it, the ink goes invisible.
he pulls out a small ball that kind of looks like a beehive cluster. He says, well, this was supposed to be a magical head for a wand of summon bee swarm. It did not work out.
What went wrong?
Now when you use it, you get swarmed in bees.
Wait, you don't think I can use that?
Interesting, but next
thing. There's an item I saw one time.
Out of character, can I actually ask you a question?
Yeah.
Can I do a roll to get, like, a like, for him to reach into that pile and get, like, something worthwhile?
Out of a junk pile?
Yeah.
Likely not.
Out of a random number, just slightly better than other things.
If you can roll a double odd, sure.
A what?
Roll two d10s, and if they both hit zero, you win.
Flat one?
These.
This one?
Yes. There's two of them. If you can roll double zero, you win.
Well, then I'm definitely not getting that. I got zero and a five.
That's close.
Yeah.
That is close.
Can I re-roll the five just to see?
Nope. I mean, you can roll it. I don't care, but...
I got a seven. Whatever. Anyway, last item. That'll be the last one that I'll ask if they can pull out of the pile. Oh, what?
It's like a blanket of fingernails.
Let's see here.
A bass-boosted fart machine.
It's a hoodie with Kim Jong-un's face on it.
Damn.
It's actually a mundane item.
It actually morphs with your character, so it just keeps his face on it.
Ooh, I do want to ask him about this wand that I got. Or, well, no, there's no point in that. Could I trade him the wand? For something good?
I mean, yeah, you could sell him the wand or something. I mean, if you're wanting something good, don't ask him to pull it out of the shit box. That's
No. I want to look through the pile, but I also want to see if I can trade him this wand for like one of his good items. So I can't use the wand, really.
You could use it with Shillelagh.
Yeah. Or I could get a club.
Or a club. Yeah.
Club.
Bonk.
Are you looking up items?
Yeah, I'm looking at just random bullshit. See which ones I like.
I'll just do one more item and then we can go ahead.
I like this. Okay. Okay, I like this one. Alright. He pulls out a box. He pulls out a box that appears to be extremely thick, though small.
Same.
It's like a cheese wheel. Yeah. He opens it up a little bit, and nothing really happens, but inside of it, you see a necklace that is absolutely just adorned with jewels, right?
Mm-hmm.
and at the base of it is an eye-shaped aperture for a gem, but instead of a gem on the inside of it, all you see are two silver lips.
No.
What does this do?
He says, well, this one was supposed to be for warriors to wear. It was supposed to give them the ability to fight harder, run faster, you know, it's supposed to make them just all around better fighters, but something went wrong in the translation when I was reading the scroll to make it. I don't know. I burned the damn thing after making this horrible contraption. But it's an amulet of encouragement.
What does it do? What does it say?
Put it on.
Put it
on. Just now do something. Anything, really.
Jump.
Whenever you jump up into there, the amulet immediately screams in a loud fucking voice. Like, you could hear it across the block. Just screams, oh, yeah! Yeah! You jump so high! Woo!
I'm buying the shit out. How much fucking money is this goddamn?
It says, give me another 25 and it's yours.
Alright. I ain't even worried about it.
Whenever you purchase it, the amulet screams, yeah, spend that money!
Alright, I'm happy.
Alright. Put that on your horse.
Now you hobble away.
Unbreak that leg!
Alright, now that that's over with.
I'm sorry.
That page is gonna be wonderful. I'm starring that page.
You're welcome.
Oh. Alright, so you guys have got your information. Ryan is asleep.
No, I'm awake, barely.
It is almost 11 o'clock. Do we want to call it now and actually get to the fighting next time, or do you want to continue?
Yes.
Probably. I have work tomorrow.
Okay.
So I gotta be up at like 6.
Yeah, you probably want to be in bed then. We'll we'll continue this next time.
Quick question. Am I always forever wearing this necklace now?
Only whenever you're not taking it off, I guess. You're currently wearing it.
Yeah, I'm not taking it off. So every time we do a fight, is it gonna pop up and do like be there? Because I fucking hope so.
Now that thing is pretty much gonna be bugging you the entire fucking game as long as you're wearing it.
I'm gonna need you to